Hello, welcome to the Redmen TV. Liverpool just kicked off the 1920 campaign with a 4-1 win over Norwich City at Anfield. And yeah, look, the game was done and dusted in the first half, really. You can see straight off the bat what a good side Norwich are. Their attacking movement is absolutely first rate, causes so many problems. And look, be careless to say they deserve anything less than a goal. You deserve probably two or three on the balance of play at times, but you know, Liverpool flexed the muscles when they needed to. Bit of a lucky own goal really to kick things off, but as a result of great pressure that we've been building, great to see Divock Origi getting an assist, banging a goal in as well, because obviously so much criticism about Liverpool not strengthened, particularly the forward positions. That's why Divock's there, because look, you know, do you want him starting every week over Sadio Mane? No. But you want him to be able to come in against teams that he supports, you know, at this level. And higher, to be perfectly honest, given that he scored a goal in the Champions League final, and do the business. You know, we saw this a couple of times from last season, scored important goals, but scored, you know, good, solid goals along the way. And that bodes very, very well for Liverpool. Stretching it, stretching defences, getting into the box, sticking the ball in the back of the net. Good on Divock Origi. Roberto Firmino, great to see him tearing around the pitch tirelessly, picking up what he left off in the Community Shield. Mo Salah looks like he's going to be an even bigger threat this season. Doesn't, you know, you're hoping he gets two or three, and it's just to get his goal scored, his goal tally well underway. But you know, again, so sharp, picking the ball up, dangerous direct running, brilliant. For me, I thought Jordan Henderson was man of the match today. Phenomenal performance. You know, look, he's up for Europe's best midfielder in the UCL awards, and you know, look, he's the captain that lifted the European Cup. He got a phenomenal reception from the cop at the end of the game, which I'll put in my vlog over on Mates TV, which will be out later tonight, so go and check that out. I'll annotate that at the end of this video, of course. But he was brilliant. He was everywhere. You know, maybe 10 minutes to warm into the game, but after that, absolutely brilliant. On the front foot, trying to make things happen, through balls. It forces a world-class save out of Tim Krul. I have no idea how he keeps that out. No idea whatsoever. So unlucky not to get a goal, but his performance warranted. I thought, well, Trent good on the right, Robbo good on the left. And great to see Sadio Mane coming off the bench as well, looking sharp, looking like a genuine world-class player that he is. Which again bodes very well for the Super Cup in midweek. Big disappointment, of course, seeing Alisson Becker going off the pitch with what looked like a calf strain. You know, he pulled up, he held on to it, looked like he was going to play a quick one out to the left. Held on for a second, it was still there, he played it awkwardly, and he kind of slipped, went down almost immediately, looked like he was going to be stretched off. He ends up walking off the pitch with a little bit of assistance. All of our fingers and toes crossed there then. Adrian comes on, gets a great reception. Look, can't really judge him on that. His distribution's nothing like Alisson Becker's, of course, and he looks a little unsettled because, look, he's not been with the squad, he's not training with the squad, he's not playing with the squad. I bet Simon Mignolet is fucking kicking himself somewhere right now, and he should be, because he should really still be here. But there you go. Look, what we might have to see Adrian in midweek, but look, hopefully it's not too serious for Alisson. If you're going to get an injury, get it in a game where literally the game's pretty much done and dusted. We went and got the fourth goal after the fact, put the game to bed in the first half. Shame we couldn't kick on and get more just to beat the goal difference up. It's stupid to be talking about that so early, but maybe just to lay a marker down. You know, West Ham hosting Man City Saturday early kickoff. It'd be nice for them to think, you know, even if we win 4-0, we wouldn't be ahead of Liverpool. But just the goal difference kick the season off, and plenty to improve on. Bit sloppy at the back of times. We'll have to get better, we'll have to get tighter as the season goes on, and of course we will, to be perfectly honest. But you know, it's not going to harm Alisson's golden glove chances, that's something. So there's a positive to take away. And look, the Reds were absolutely irresistible, and you know, it's going to get better than this. Very, very similar to the West Ham game last season for me. We showed what we could do, but we also showed there's so many more gears to go up in, and that is the most encouraging thing to take away from this. But yes, right now, right here, Liverpool on top of the Premier League. Isn't that wonderful? Enjoy Friday night. Enjoy the entire weekend calendar of football, because we can, because Liverpool have got 3 points on the board, kicked the Premier League season off the way we wanted to, and left us tantalisingly wanting more. Not too long to wait. Super Cup to come. Subscribe to the Redmen TV YouTube channel. And of course, the post-match podcast will have Chris's player ratings in as well, if you listen to this in audio form. And if you want my match vlog from this, head over to Mates TV as well. Thank you, everyone.